All right, so here's a C4 1690 horsepower Vette. Gonna be tearing the streets up of Missouri soon. So today, I'm giving you an update on this Corvette that we're doing an engine install in. We put one of our all Darth Vader black 427 small block hot rod series twin turbo engines in. It's featuring our alien intake manifold that's got the 16 injectors all hidden on the inside with the built-in fuel regulation. Billet valve covers, twin turbocharged with the NRE patented mirror image turbos. We've got our 72 millimeter turbochargers on this, and in this installation we went ahead and welded on V-bands to the turbocharger itself, and then hard piped to some big K&N air cleaners here. So we've got your two air intake tubes, pretty mean looking, coming off the turbos, getting fresh air. Some other things that are kind of neat here is this is an all custom fabricated radiator housing shroud setup. So we got a Ron Davis radiator. This whole radiator here, it's all been fabbed to get as much fan as we can possibly get in this car. So we've actually staggered the fans in the car. And then in front of that, we've got an air-to-air intercooler. So you've got basically air feeding in to the intercooler, and then it goes down the intercooler. And again, I can show you that once we get it lifted up. We've got some of our pretty cool and new prototype billet breather systems that have a really trick baffle system inside. So these are going to replace the actual breather cans. So if you take a look on the top, you'll just see some nice clean billet breathers that go into the covers themselves. You can kind of get a good view of the alien intake right there. We went and converted this car to a Billet Specialties drive unit, so it has a real nice high amp alternator, air conditioning, power steering, the whole shebang. Again, black anodized, all of that. You can kind of see our custom stainless head work that we went ahead and ceramic coated black. We've got some, you know, punch flare gussets holding the wastegate assembly. And of course, all the hard lines, everything's been plumbed in seamless stainless hard lines. You can kind of see some of that there. The blow off valves running out to the wastegate, oil feed to the turbo. The vet was kind of a difficult deal on the throttle linkage, so we've made this, you know, kind of elaborate throttle linkage setup. Here, going through the firewall, and I'll join it up there. And obviously, those are the fuel regulators that are built into the manifold itself. What's been kind of trick with this whole system is that we've left the factory AC intact. You left the factory brake booster, all of that stuff. The customer, you know, opted to keep all, even the batteries in the front. You know, so. This is truly 10 pounds of shit in a 1 pound bag. It's a bitch to work on. So here's a view of the Vette on the lift. It's 1690 horsepower is what it made, so this is going to be a pretty little crazy little ride. You can see from the front here we ended up making this air scoop, and we did that for multiple reasons. One is to force air into the radiator, but also to force cold air into the intercooler itself. So it's got this huge mouth that's just feeding air, and it's all kind of blocked off in the back there. It's kind of a little crazy looking. Some other cool things that we kind of did just to clean some things up is we went ahead and, you know, we brushed all the control arms and lower control arms and such, and just kind of cleaned it up a little bit. I know the owner doesn't care if it's a show car, but it does show pretty well. Here's another neat feature that we've fabricated on the car is we've made this rear, I guess, you know, the factory Corvettes, they have like a rear bumper assembly. So we've TIG'd up this rear bumper assembly, and now it's holding two fuel tanks. We've got one large fuel tank, which is 91 octane, and then the second fuel tank is 116 octane, and that's what we call octane on demand. And they both have rollovers. Feeds and returns are all built in. The pumps are submersed in the tank, fuel senders. You know, it's kind of cool, a little artsy strap that we got going on to hold it all in, and you know, it's all hand fabricated here at Nelson Racing. So here's the aeromotive fuel pump and filters. There's a pre-filter and an after filter, and the pump mounted inside the tank where we've made little punch flares and reinforcements inside the tank. And that goes out to the primary tank right here. Fuel sender, and then your fills and everything as your secondary tank. Though all the whole fuel cell and everything is empty, you can kind of get a view of the flow. Dual stainless 3-inch, all TIG'd up. Kind of get a view of the undercarriage right there. You can see right here we've got our coil pack DFUs mounted right there. We've done all hard piping of the water lines and the intercooler lines themselves. Still need to obviously touch up some things on the bottom. It's still under construction, but you know, the brushed A-arms and such like that.
It is pretty rad though that you could have something that got pulling 18 inches of manifold vacuum.
Right.
You know, I could drive that thing anywhere I want in the country, mm-hmm, and crap out 1,000 on pump.
Right.
Tune up, you know.
Yeah, thank you very much.
So the customer will ultimately end up taking it and putting all new rear suspension and rear end in it and kind of do his final touches to it. But our goal here is get it lit up and running under its own power, and it'll get finished out. And but just showing you some of the detail work that's been done. You know, we say this all the time, but this really is like it's just an amazing thing to be able to have a motor that makes 18 inches of manifold vacuum, and you know, poop out 1,070 horsepower at 15 pounds, and then 1,680 horsepower at 36, and with a lot more left. You know, we came out with this Alien 5 years ago on the small blocks, and leading up to it was 10 years of, you know, research up to make this to where it is, and it just gets better every year. And this is my favorite engine. It's a, you know, I mean, it may not be the most powerful, but I think it's the sexiest. Again, those are patented mirror image turbos that took 3.5 years just for the patent. 2 years to develop this intake, our billet valve covers, some of our stainless headers. I mean, it's just a really nice package. You get so much for the money.
And it's just gorgeous. I love this thing.